Fellow viewers, myself, Mrs. M. Govindamal, Assistant Professor of Commerce, SFR College for Women, Sivakasi. Now I am going to discuss about functions of DBMS. Functions can be classified into several types. First one, transaction management. Second, concurrency control. Third one, recovery management. Fourth one, security management. Fifth one, language interface. Sixth one, storage management. Seventh one, data catalog management. Now let us see transaction management. Transaction management is a sequence of database operations that represent a logical unit of work and that access a database and transform it from one state to another. A transaction can update a record, delete one, modify a set of records, etc. When the DBMS does a commit, the changes made by the transactions are made permanent. If the user does not want to make the changes permanent, the user can roll back the transaction and the database will remain in its original state. Now let us see concurrency control. The concurrency control is the database management's activity of coordinating the actions of database manipulation process that operate concurrently and access shared data that interfering with one another. The goal of the ideal concurrency management mechanism is to allow the concurrency while maintaining the consistency of the shared data. Next one. Now let us see the recovery management. The recovery management system is a database ensures that the aborted or failed transactions create to adverse the effects on the database, the other's transactions. The recovery mechanism is a DBMS, make sure that the database is returned to a consistent state after a transaction fails or abort. Recovery is very much related to concurrency in the sense that the more concurrency, the more is the chance that an aborted transaction can affect many other transactions. Now let us see security management. The security refers to the protection of data against unauthorized access. Security mechanism of a DBMS makes sure that only authorized users are given the right access to the data in the database. The level of access for each user and the operations that each user can perform on the data will be monitored and controlled by the DBMS depending on the access privilege of the users. Next, we move on, language interface. The DBMS provides language for the definition and manipulation of data in the database. The data structures are created using the data definition language commands. The data manipulation is done using the data manipulation commands. By providing the language support for the data definition and manipulation, the database creates an environment where the user can do their job without worrying about their physical implementations. Next, we move on, storage management. The DBMS provides a mechanism for the management of permanent storage of the data. The internal scheme defines how the data should be stored by the storage management mechanism, and the storage manager interfaces with operating system to access the physical storage. A storage manager supports block-oriented access to disk files, buffering of blocks, splitting logical files over multiple volumes. The logical files larger than the maximum size of the physical files allowed by the operating system. Next, we move on, data catalog management. Data catalog is a system database that contains description of the data in the database. It contains information about data, relationships, constraints, and the entire schema that organizes the features into unified database. The database catalog can be queried to get information about the structure of the database. These are all the functions of DBMS. Thank you.